Welcome to the lovely Holland's Wood in the New Forest and a little video about our auto sleeper symbol from 2005. This is the ES model, which means that it has four travelling seats rather than three, but we'll get into that in more detail when we look inside. From the outside, this is the passenger side, and you have the door on this side because it's a British van conversion. So when you stop on the side of the road, this is the side that opens, the near side, which is nice and safe, as opposed to some European models where it's on the other side. Access to the Thetford cassette toilets is here, and we have a little electric step and a hard high top. On this side, we have the fridge vent covers. Well, the fridge vents, the covers are on at the moment because I'm not using the fridge. Electric hookup point, the exhaust for the water heater. The water heater will not work if the cover for this is on. If you try and light your water heater and it just you keep getting a red light and you don't know why, check you haven't got the cover on. Fresh water point, and underneath here you have exhaust taps for your grey water tank and your fresh water tank, and the exhaust of the car. And that's it. And this is the inside of the van. As you can see on the right hand side, we have one of the beds made up during the day to be used as a sofa. To do this, the front driver's seat pushes all the way forward and is tilted forward, and an extra cushion is put in the end to make a single bed. It's about, I think, 5'6" long, because I'm 5'6" and my feet touch the end. On the ES model, the front driver's seat does turn around, and this folds back into a seat for travelling with a seat belt. And the other travelling seat is here with a seat belt, currently occupied. So this side also turns into a single bed. So the passenger seat facing forward, pushed forward, tilted forward, and an extra cushion put in, and this bottom bit slides along to make this bit slides out to make a full single bed. So you can have two single beds, or you can add, there's a thing that slides out under here and you can fill in with cushions, and you can make a double bed that goes across the van. So when you're traveling, these seats obviously both face forward, and you have a seat here for a passenger with a seat belt, and a seat here for a passenger with a seat belt. On the non-ES, on the standard model, this is always a bench and can't be converted into an extra travelling seat. Some nice little touches, TV table up here. If you don't have a TV, works quite well with a tablet on a stand for watching TV in the evening, and a plug socket. We quite like this little sound square. It's a little Bluetooth speaker. It's perfect for the van. Battery lasts for ages, well, loud enough. Tables, there are table points. These are homemade mats. These aren't original. In here you have points for a table, which can go, if I pull them out of the way, that'll go back in. There's another point under there, and there is a long table here tucked in behind there, and there is a smaller table stored inside the cupboard there. So you can have both tables out, or one table out, and you can have it in the middle, or you can have it on the sides. So you can have sort of a, if you have both as benches and the table in the middle, the big one, it's a bit like a galley. Or you can have two seats with a small table in between. It's a lot of flexibility. The legs are stored up here. There's one on either side, so you can have both tables out at the same time. Big storage cupboard up here for the cushions and bedding and things like that. What are these called? Windows. one on either side. A roof light up there, which is lovely. a vent here, and there's another one in the bathroom. I'll show you that in a minute. What else have we got going on? Cooker. We've got the full cooker in this one. Oven, grill, 3 hobs. It's great, actually. Didn't think I'd need an oven, but now I've got one, it's quite useful. The sink. So you have hot and cold water and a sink, which this clips up there. So you have a draining board and quite a decent sized sink to wash up with. And then when you're not using it, this folds down to make either half workspace or all workspace. You have a very big area for cooking, which is terrific. And also this little cupboard folds down, so there's another little bit there. Lots of storage, lots of little cupboards and bigger cupboards and all over the place. We also have plenty of lighting. We've got a light here and a light up there. This is a very small little cupboard at the end that just bits and bobs, kites and hot cross buns. Here we have a control panel, so master switch, thing for how much battery or how much water you've got left, water pump, lights, and this is when you're plugged in, whether you want to charge your habitation battery or your vehicle battery. Curtain at the back. Blind. You've got blinds that do that, or that do that, which is nice. And curtains and blinds on these windows, so it's nice and warm, actually. Toilet. So, oh, fridge. So I think they're called combi fridge. It runs off the car battery, the leisure battery, or gas, and some little drawers and things. There's not an awful lot of storage space in here, to be honest. If you've got the cushions to make up the double bed, then they live in here, and this cupboard is basically full. But we just leave them at home. This is technically the wardrobe, or the junk cupboard. Gas bottles go down there. And there's another little bottle up here, a bottle, little cupboard up there for some bits and bobs. Bought one of these memo boards, they're sticky, and it's really useful. Anyway, bathroom. So the door to the bathroom, it's a bit hard to show you this. I'll just let it swing open and, yeah. So this folds out. You undo that clip. You do that, and then you do that, and it comes across, and it gets fastened in. Oops, there, you can see that, and then it basically doubles the size of your bathroom. So if you're having a shower or you want to get changed at the back of the van, it's very useful. Neat little thing. If you don't use it, it's just a door. And in here we have a hand basin with taps and a little cabinet for your bits and bobs and a shower and the shower thing and a toilet, a Thetford cassette toilet and another air vent and light, obviously. So it's quite a decent size for a small van. You have a nice sized shower room in there and facilities. Ooh. So yes. And I think that's everything. We have Jake. We have Gonzo. And we have Finn. A couple of things I've just remembered I forgot to show you. One is the heating. So this has a little heater that runs off the fuel in the diesel tank. We've tested it. We've had it running all weekend over a long bank holiday weekend, and the fuel gauge just didn't move. So it uses barely any fuel. And you get some nice warm air coming out of a vent down here, which is nice. And it heats up the van incredibly quickly. Also, we have down here water heater, which is great. It's nice to have hot water, and another plug socket. Oh, and on this side, underneath this chair, we have another place for storage. So we have this, which we keep the hookup cable in. Now there you go. And we have a small dog. He's very sleepy. I can't really show you the cab very well because I've got the seats turned around and I've got watering cans and things in the way. It's a Peugeot Boxer, the base model, the base vehicle, and it's got a 2-litre diesel engine. It's 10 years old. It's not the peppiest vehicle on the road, but it chips along and it's quite comfortable to drive. You've got some nice armrests when you're driving, and a very good view. Hello, pony.